Hey guys, I want to talk about what to do and how to act when your staff fuck up. This is a particularly difficult one when it's something that's important. They should know exactly what to do, or you've explained it to them really carefully, told them how important it is, made sure that they understood, you know, do you get it? Yeah, got it, boss, for sure. And then they do it wrong. And we've all been there, and it's really, really, really annoying. Depending on who you are and where you're at, you may blow your top. I've certainly been there plenty of times where it's like, and I just want to yell on the screen. There's other times where I just internalize it and I'm like, oh, I can't. But the feeling's the same. Whether you let it out or whether it's inside, you're like, oh my God. Like, you should know better. Doesn't matter if it's an apprentice. If it's an apprentice who should know better, then yeah, because they're brand new, then you don't get annoyed. It's when someone should know better, especially if it's, you know, a carpenter or someone you're paying really good money to. And you've explained it to them and they get it, and then they go and wreck it anyway. And it's going to cost you time and money, a lot more time to fix than it would have just to do it right in the first time. So, what do you do? Well, here's the hard bit. Every time one of your staff fails, it's because you failed as a manager. And that's really hard to swallow, yeah? But if you can take that on board, you will fly ahead as a manager and as a leader of people. And also, you will find you get your staff performing a lot better. So, yeah, the scenario I'm talking about is like, you know, okay, this is really important, we need to do it this way. I'm gonna explain it to you. And you explain it step by step by step to them, and then you say this, okay, do you get me? And they're like, yep, I got you. Do you have any questions? No. Nah. You all clear? Yep. Right? In their head, they're going, no, I'm not clear, but I don't want to look stupid. Hello, mister. I don't want to look like an idiot in front of the boss. I don't want to look like I can't understand. So I would rather say yes, and you know what? I'm a smart guy. I know what I'm doing. I'll figure it out. I'll make it work, yeah? So they nod along. No questions. No, all good. Yeah, no. I'm going to need it. Trust me, I'll make it work. But then they don't. Now, the reality is, if you walk away at that point, have you failed as a manager? Well, you've given them instructions that they have not understood. And you haven't realized as a manager that even though they're saying yes, what they mean is no. So your failure as a manager was actually not realizing that they don't understand, and that their ego is getting in the way of them asking questions, because they don't want to look like an idiot in front of their boss. They don't want to have you think less of them. And they think they're probably smart enough to figure it out. They've got enough experience to do that, right? So you've got to come up with a way to, as a manager, know when that's the case, or to pick that. Like, the military does this in a very simple way. They give an order and then you have to repeat the order straight back to them. You know, I've never been in the military and I think that I can see how it would work, but it feels pretty demeaning. Yeah, it does. It feels pretty demeaning to most people who don't know that. Yeah, repeat to me what I just said to you. They're like, fuck mate, I'm in the army here. So I'll often go, hey, so do you get that? And they'll go, yep. I'm going, awesome. Well, mate, everyone's going to do it slightly differently. I know how I do it. Can you just talk me through how you would do that? Are you talking me through how you would do it, are you? You're gonna talk me through how you would do it, is that right? Yeah, say hi. This is my youngest, this is Rannick. Hi. Yeah, am I failing as a father, am I, to understand your signs right now? Mm-hmm. So I get them to talk me through how they would do it. And by, you know, taking the edge off the question, I'm not saying, dude, I don't trust that you really know when you say that you do understand it. I'm just saying, okay, cool, man. Obviously, you have got it. Everyone's going to do it differently. You know, there's 20 different ways to hang a door. There's 20 different ways to skin a cat. I'm just curious to see if I can learn. Can you talk me through how you're going to do this? And you just get them, you just listen while I talk through the way they are going to approach it. And that, you know, gives you, if there's any gaps in their understanding, it gives you the chance to spot those. You know, you've got to think about other ways you can do it as well. That's just one tool that I've used. But the key thing to remember is if your staff have fucked up, it is actually your fault. And I can hear some of you going, you probably turn it off right now. That's fine. But life will get better, business will get better, you'll get more performance out of you guys if you can take that on board. Now, it may only be 2% of it that's your fault and 98% that says, right, what 2% can you improve on? That will make you a better leader, a better manager, and we'll get a better result next time. Because the reality is, their failure is yours. You know, at the end of the day, you're responsible for their actions and their behavior. So you need to go, how do I change my behaviors as a manager in order to get a different result? And if there's nothing that I can do that will get a different result from this individual, then they shouldn't be part of your team. It's not that hard. Your job as a manager is actually to remove them from your team and remove them from your business. If you cannot get a different result, no matter what you do. If you can get a different result, if there's a way to get a different result, it's your responsibility to do that. That's your job as a manager, as a leader. So find out, think it through, come up with ideas. What could you have done differently that would have achieved a different result from that person? Because it's actually your failure. Bitter pill to swallow, but it makes a huge difference once you can make that mental leap. It's confronting when that anger that you want to explode out or internalize is actually going to be directed at yourself. But that's your role as a manager, actually, is to go, shit, I've got to improve and get better. And then you get your staff better. Hope that's helped. And if you've watched through to the end, you're probably a long way towards being the leader you need to be, because those who can't stomach this quite yet, have got a ways to go. And that's all right too. Everyone will walk their own journey. Good luck with yours, guys.